Welcome to the Boxing Talk Show, Fair but Firm, with the Hall of Fame boxing referee.
I'm Joe Cortez.
And co-host John Zamel, in English and Spanish for all of Las Vegas.
Come on, guys, let's touch them up. Clean fight. I'm Joe Cortez, Fair but Firm.
Hey, guys, welcome to the Fair but Firm show here with my co-host John Zamel. Joe Cortez here talking about extra time. A little bit about what happened Saturday night in Madison Square Garden. We had Vasyl Lobachenko versus Jorge Linares. Hey guys, that was a great fight.
Yeah.
In the sense that, I mean, great because there was a great accomplishment. Mm-hmm. History was making Saturday night.
Yeah.
Because Lobachenko, with only 12 fights under his belt, is already a 3-time world champion in 3 different weight classes. Nobody's ever done that in such a short period of time. And but he got a little scared there.
Oh yeah.
In the sixth round, when he got dropped with that right hand from Linares.
Right
now, John, Linares is a veteran, been there, one of the top fighters.
Oh yeah.
In the lightweight division, but Lomachenko, he was focused and he wanted to get that one more division. And you know, I don't think he's finished there yet.
That's my next question. But first, I want to talk about that knockdown, that flash knockdown, because. We've seen it in the past. Actually, it reminded me of the Rocky Martinez when he dropped Mikey Garcia very quickly, and then Mikey Garcia got up and made his name for himself. We see a lot of guys that just take big shots and they get a little bit shaky. I mean, remember when Floyd Mayweather fought Shane Mosley?
Yeah.
And he took that big shot? The whole rest of that round, he was a little bit hesitant.
Yeah, well, it happened in Boston when I refereed my 1 minute Marquez, Manny Pacquiao. Pacquiao had Marquez down 3 times in the first round. And, you know, I saw those flash knockdowns. So, of course, you know, we look and see the eyes are still there. They're not really
yes.
out of focus. They're still pretty sharp, and that's what happened Saturday night with Lomachenko.
Yeah, you think of that famous Prince Nassim versus Kevin Kelly fight.
Yeah.
There was a bunch of knockdowns there, and one thing fans, I think not everybody realizes, is that not all knockdowns are created equally. Some knockdowns really put some damage on you. Sometimes you just kind of get caught off guard. It's not a slip. It's a genuine knockdown, but it's what's called a flash knockdown because it's just a little hit.
Yeah, and there's some fighters in the first rounds, then I warm up enough.
Mm-hmm.
They either look bad or sometimes they get dropped and then they wake up.
Yes.
And then they have a decent fight after that.
And that's kind of what we saw. We saw for the first time, we saw a hesitant Vasyl Lomachenko. We saw him for the rest of that sixth, I think. I don't think anything more than that, but he was a little bit like, okay, now I need to take this guy a little more seriously. I was trying to finish him. After that, he regained control like true champions do. Right. And he showed us all why he's the best. I mean, that combination, that the way that he went into that with that big jab and then the barrage of hooks, and then he faked the shoulder fake, the right shoulder.
He did a feint.
And then, yes, the shoulder feint. And he put his hands up because he didn't want to get hit with another one of those hooks. Left his liver completely exposed.
Yeah.
And that was a good night. That was the second liver shot he took.
Yeah, but, you know, Lomachenko getting dropped for the first time in his career, it's a good thing because, I mean, it makes you a better fighter.
Absolutely.
I mean, you can't take nobody for granted.
That's what it shows you.
You learn something. You go back to the drawing board and say, what kind of mistake did I make there? Did I get too comfortable there at that moment or what?
It'd be understandable.
Yeah. So I mean, he's only human. I mean, Muhammad Ali and some of the great ones, Sugar Ray Robinson,
yes.
Some of the great fighters of all time have gotten dropped at one time or another, have gotten up. And
you keep fighting,
cases,
man.
You keep fighting. That's what makes a real champion.
Absolutely.
Get up off the deck, get up. And so
like a fight. Rocky movie, right?
Yeah.
Like we always talk about when you come back through adversity, like Andre Ward in the first one.
Yeah. I was working a corner. Actually, I came out with the Devin Haney Friday night on Showtime, a new generation, a young kid, only 19 years of age. I met him when he was 14. He looked great Friday night, beating Mason Menard, who had a record like 32 wins, 24 knockouts, only 2 losses.
Yeah, he's a good fighter.
Yeah, and this kid, Devin Haney, remember the name? Devin Haney, and check him out on YouTube. The kid is an excellent boxer. He only got hit one time Friday night by a punch, a left hook that he caught from Mason Menard. This kid, Devin Haney, just caught it like nothing hit. He just kept on going.
Yeah,
that was
Terminator.
That's the only punch he got hit with all night long. He couldn't hit it.
Menard, no jabs, no nothing?
Mason couldn't hit him with a jab, nothing.
Wow.
Even though punch shots got him, that he got hit so many punches. I didn't see anything like that.
One real connection.
Yeah, he was blocking punches. If the stats that they were showing.
You know how CompuBox is a little bit flawed because it's hard to tell.
It's
man.
Hard to tell for the angle. But for what I saw, he didn't get hit only with that one punch. He's going places 19-0 with 13 knockouts. Devin Haney, remember that name.
He's a superstar. But let's go back to Vasily real quick.
Yeah.
Because what he did really is historic, not just in you know, on statistics. It's amazing to go up three different weight classes as quickly as he did at 30 years old and be able to capture those. Now, first of all, we just, on our last show, on our main podcast, Not the Extra Time, we talked to Ricky Gonzalez, who was the referee in that fight, and he said he'd never seen anything like him. Fans echo that sentiment all the time. Right. We've heard everyone from Joe Rogan to Max Kellerman basically say that exact same thing. I'm asking you, being the boxing expert, the resident everything on this show, have you ever seen anybody fight the way that he fights, the way he finds angles, the way that he does things the way he does them?
He's a fighter that has super talent. I mean, I've been around boxing most of my life. I can tell you, as a referee for 35 years, he has superb talent. He has great rim mechanics. He has good punching power. And to only have 12 pro fights under his belt is unheard of.
Yeah.
He had 396 amateur fights with only one loss and was two-time Olympic champion. So it says a lot about Vasily Lomachenko, a great fighter, has a great resume already. But 30 years of age, at the rate he's going, he's still got a couple of more, three or four, five more years left in boxing.
Absolutely.
Easy. And with the style that he has, he could probably even last longer because he doesn't get hit that much.
He's cerebral, too.
Yeah, exactly.
But that's what I'm saying. His fighting style, the way that he fights, does it remind you of anybody else? Or is it truly as revolutionary as people say?
You know, he's really an outstanding boxer. It's very rare that you're going to find a fighter with his talent.
Yes.
I can say that.
It's like a one-of-a-kind type of fighter.
Yeah,
hard to copy.
Come around maybe once every 50 years, that kind of a fighter. And now I'm saying that he's number one in the last 50 years, but
I know what you're saying.
But he's definitely one of the outstanding ones, what he has accomplished with only 12 pro fights under his belt.
So where does he go from here, man? Well, he's at 135 right now.
Well, I'd like to see him against Mickey Garcia. That's one of the other lightweights out there.
He should fight at 135 fight, right?
Well, yeah, 135 is good, but if he goes to go to 140, there's plenty of competition there as well, which I'm sure he can handle.
Mikey Garcia just won the belt at 140 and then just relinquished it.
Yeah, he relinquished that belt and now he's back down to 135.
So if he wants to get a title, he has to fight him at 135, unify.
Well, there's other championship belts, other sanctioning bodies out there by Mikey Garcia. But, I mean, Mikey...
he's fighting Easter, though, right now.
He fighting Robert Easter.
Absolutely.
Which I think I don't see any problem, too much problem there. Robert Easter is a good fighter.
Robert Easter is good. He's undefeated for a reason, but he's never fought anybody.
Yeah.
I mean, we'll see if he's for real right now, but nothing that we've seen would indicate he could fight a Mikey Garcia.
Well, my guy, the guy that I'm working with, one of my young fighters, is Devin Haney, and I'm glad I'm part of that team because I'm a consultant with the team, and I would like to see him fight soon, perhaps even before the end of the year. We thought that Robert Easter would be a good opponent for Devin Haney, for a simple reason that I say he's only 19, but remember, Mike Tyson became a heavyweight champion at the age of 20. And he was a superstar coming up through the 8 rounds, 10 round fights, and whatnot coming up. And I think it is before he was 20, when he was 20, he was already world champion.
Mm-hmm.
Devin Haney, I can see him doing the same because he's that good of a fighter. And a fighter to fight. And only get hit one time, but anyway.
My goodness, I love watching these young guys.
Yeah,
and I think, especially when you see a Lomachenko who fought such a long storied career like he did, and then to come out like out of a cannon into the pros.
Right.
You see other guys that are trying to follow that model. You see like Gervonta Tank Davis is trying to, Ryan Garcia, all these guys that you hear about. I think that guy, Daniil Yeluzhinov, I think he'll be fighting for one of the 147-pound titles within his first 10 fights. And I've said that in the past. I think I that kid looks so good last, and that's a crazy division right now.
Exactly.
Do you see that being a model that a lot of fighters are going to try and without like rather than building their resume, you think they're going to come out of a cannon now that we've seen Lomachenko do it, or do you think he's?
You saw what happened the other night with Salam Ali.
Oh yeah. Sometimes you fly too high too fast.
Yeah, this kid from Tijuana came out there.
Jaime Munguia.
He looked good. Been stopping.
He did look good. 4 rounds. How many knockdowns? Like five?
There were 4 knockdowns.
Yeah.
But I think Saddam Ali was out of his weight class.
Undeniably. He didn't look comfortable the whole time. It wasn't the same Saddam Ali that fought Cotto.
No, he got hit.
It wasn't even the same one that lost to Vargas.
He got hit. I mean, he fought the guy Cotto, and Cotto couldn't hurt him.
No.
And but then this kid,
Munguia.
Munguia. Jaime Munguia for Tijuana. He's a young fighter. He has a potentials.
He looks good
in the middleweight division.
And then Which is a scary division.
Yeah, there's another young kid named Joey Spencer from Michigan. He only has two professional fights under his belt. Has two knockouts, 154 pounder. And he's fighting.
How old is he?
He was just 17.
17 at 154.
They gave him a license here in Nevada because he has a super amateur background, superb. Mm-hmm. And so he's looking good.
We've had him and his dad on the show.
Yeah, Joey Spencer and his father, Jason Spencer. And I'll be working with him, too, out in California on June 10th. But there's a lot of young talent out there. They keep coming up to me for advice and whatnot. I'm trying to get them on the right track. I enjoy doing that. And I think that boxing is really going to another level with this young talent. You're going to see like a Happy Saturday Night, Showtime.
Yes.
The new generation is a great segment of Showtime.
Yes.
To bring this young talent. You can see all these fighters that were fighting on Showtime Saturday night, Friday night. They were super. They were young talent. You say, wow, these guys stand to be some world champions.
Absolutely.
World champions in the very near future. You got him on HBO, we got him on ESPN.
Yeah, you saw the same thing the week before when Golden Boy put Ryan Garcia on the May 4th ticket.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, it's amazing. We're seeing boxing at least three nights a week here. Not to mention, we just had Matchroom sign that $100 billion deal reportedly with DAZN,
yeah,
where we're going to be seeing all Matchroom fights streamed in America, which is just, I mean, huge for exposure for all those fighters.
Exactly.
We all know how big boxing is in the UK right now, and for the ability to us see that on any given, you know, without having to try and find a stream, it's kind of tough sometimes. It's really big for the sport, and we couldn't be more excited.
You can stream also for ESPN for $4.99 a month.
ESPN Plus, yeah.
ESPN Plus, don't miss that. I mean, you're really going to see it. I'm with ESPN. I can tell you, ESPN does doing such a great job with the boxing. We do ESPN Deportes, and we have ESPN Domestic, and ESPN is trying to show, have big profile fights on ESPN.
Absolutely.
Never before, and you can catch it for $4.99 a month.
I thought that they did a great job. When they first rolled out their first fights on ESPN with in the beginning here, it was a lot going on. You remember there was the two screens and then the bottom? I thought this was the cleanest look we've had of them. I loved the way they did such a great job with the Lomachenko fight, and I'm looking forward to the Terrence Crawford fight, watching it on ESPN just because of that.
Exactly.
I mean, it's exciting, and boxing's exciting.
I said James Crawford,
Terrence
Crawford, and Jeff Horn fighting June 10th, June 9th here in Las Vegas.
Going to be the MGM.
At the MGM Hotel, so watch that. You can't miss it. This is going to be a great fight. It's all going to be on ESPN as well. So.
Absolutely, man. Boxing's in great hands. You saw Errol Spence already almost sold out Texas already. And it's like 16,000 seats, and he already has almost 10,000 sold.
Yeah.
It's amazing, man. Yeah. And that fight's not for 2 months.
Right. Fans, we're going to cut it short for now. This is our extra time. God bless. Take care. Keep your guards at all time. Remember, I'm fair, but I'm firm. Bang, bang, bing. Touch them up.